Hello students, welcome back. Now we will start a very important topic of series and sequence, arithmetico. Geometric progression. Clearly, it will have an arithmetic progression as well as a geometric progression as well. Means, in short, we can say A, G, P. We know that AP is denoted by A. A1 is first term. A1 plus D, D is common difference. A1 plus 2D, D is common difference. A1 is first term. A1 plus 3D is third term. And so on. And GP is denoted by first term is A2. First term of AP is A1. First term of GP is A2. And if common ratio is R, so A2R, A2R square, A2R cube, and so on. Now, what is AGP? So, AGP is obtained by the product of corresponding terms of an arithmetic progression and a geometric progression. For example, first term is A1 into A2. Means first term of AP is multiplied with first term of GP. Then, second term of AP, A1 plus DB, D1 is multiplied with second term of GP plus A1 plus 2D, third term of AP is multiplied with third term of GP, and so on. So how to find the sum of AGP? And how to find the nth term of AGP? We will discuss in today's class. So first we will discuss how to find nth term of an AGP. To find the nth term of an AGP, what should we do? We multiply nth term of AP with nth term of GP. As we have observed that first term of AGP is obtained by first term of AP into first term of GP. Second term of AGP is obtained by first term of AP into first term of, second term of AP into second term of GP. Third term of AGP is obtained by the product of third term of AP and the third term of GP. Similarly, nth term of AGP is obtained by the product of nth term of AP with the nth term of GP. Nth term of AP, we know that is A1 plus N minus 1 into D1, and nth term of GP is A2 into R to the power N minus 1. We have assumed that A1 is the first term of AP, A2 is the first term of GP, D1 is the common difference of AP, R is the common ratio of GP. So in this way, we can find the nth term of AGP. Now let's discuss how to find the sum of n terms of an AGP. But remember, this is done by the method of differences, means A1 A2 plus A1 plus D1 into A2R plus A1 plus 2D1 into A2R square, and so on up to nth term A1 plus N minus 1 D1 into A2R square. So if nth term is not given, we have to first find the nth term of that AGP. Then write the term sum in terms of SN. And if it is better to write the second last term on. So remember, if you write the second right last term, what it could be? In place of this n minus 1, there will be n minus 2 in the second last term. And in place of n minus 1 in power, there will be n minus 2. And then write the last term also. A1 plus n minus 1d1 is the nth term, that is last term, into A2 into r to the power n minus 1. Now we multiply whole the sum with r. R means common ratio of GP, which we already have calculated using the GP. So multiply first term by r, A1, A2 into r. And we shift it by one place so that these two like terms are written together, leaving the space below the first term of the original sum. The second term is also multiplied by r, so it is a1 plus d1 into a2 r square. We write it below the third term and so on. So this n minus 1 term is also multiplied by r. Its power is also increased by 1. So n minus 2 plus 1, it becomes n minus 1. And the remaining is written as it is. Means this whole term, the n minus 1 term is written below the nth term as we have shifted each term by one place. So a1 plus n minus 2 d1 into this is A2 r to the power n minus 2 into r becomes A2 r to the power n minus 1. Then one more term is also there, plus this is multiplied to r, A1 plus n minus 1 d1 into A2 into r to the power n. So this is when it is shifted by one term. Then we subtract, assuming that this is the first equation and this is the second equation. We subtract equation second from one. So in this, Sn is common. We observe that Sn is common in between these two. So Sn is taken common into 1 minus r, as it is Sn minus r into Sn. So if we take Sn common between these two, it gives Sn into 1 minus r. Then first term is written as it is, as there is no term below this. Plus, now we will subtract this a1 plus d1 into a2r and minus. Sign is changed to minus. This plus is also changed to minus as we are subtracting, and so on. Up to last term, it also changes to minus, and this also changes to minus. Now, if you take A2R common between these two terms, as A2R is common in first AP and in first AGP and the second AGP. So if you take A2R common, it is A1 plus D1 minus A1 only. A1 cancelled out, so there will be D1 only into A2R. Plus again, this time A2R square is common. And if you subtract A1 minus A1 cancelled out, 2D1 minus D1, D1 only into A2R square. Means what will be the next term? It will be D1 into A2R cube. We can estimate this, and so on up to, in this again, a2r to the power n minus 1 is common between the two terms, and in this also a1 cancelled out, n minus 1 minus n minus 2, so it will also give only d1. And last term, there is nothing above it, so it should be written as it is, a1 plus n minus 1 d1 into a2 r to the power n. Now we observe that it is itself a GP starting from d1 a2 r. If we take d1 a2 r common from this, 1 plus r square and so on up to number of terms in this will be one less. Why? As we have already written one term a1 a2 outside the bracket. So it is up to n minus one terms only, and minus this term is written as it is a1 plus n minus 1 d1 into a2 r to the power n. So Sn will be obtained when we divide both sides by 1 minus r. Thus we can find the sum of an AGP with n terms. Hope you must have understood this algorithm. The first step to identify AP and GP separately, write their first terms and common difference and the common ratio separately, and then multiply common ratio with sum of n terms, and then subtract the first equation from the second to get the new equation. And now we can find the sum of this bracket by using GP. It's a GP, you can observe. So it will give the value of this AGP. Sn into 1 minus r equals to a1 a2 plus d1 a2 r into, this is GP of n terms, we know that. Formula is a into 1 minus r to the power n upon 1 minus r when r is less than 1 minus this term, last term. a1 plus n minus 1 into d1 into a2 r to the power n. So Sn will be a1 a2 upon 1 minus r plus d1 a2 r into 1 minus r to the power n upon 1 minus r whole square minus a1 plus n minus 1 into d1 into a2 r to the power n upon 1 minus r. So this is the method to solve the, to find the sum of an AGP, means arithmetical geometric progression of n terms. So one more thing which we must learn, to find the sum to infinite terms of an AGP. It can be done only when AGP has the GP with common ratio r, which is less than 1, which lies between minus 1 to 1, we can say. Okay, so sum to infinite terms of AGP and how to find this, now we will discuss that. So in this also the method will be same. First we write Sn, a1, a2 is the first term, plus a1 plus d1 is the first term of AP, a2 into r is the second term of GP and second term of AP. Third term of AP is a1 plus 2d1 into a2 r square is the third term of GP. So it forms an AGP and so on up to infinity. And remember in this, absolute value of this common ratio will be less than 1. Or we can say r lies between minus 1 to 1. This common ratio must lie between minus 1 to 1. The method is same. First we multiply by r and shift that term by one place. And so on up to infinity. Then we subtract. The first, second equation with first equation, Sn is common into 1 minus r equals to a1 a2 plus a2 r is common into d1 plus a2 r square is common into d1 and so on up to infinity. So it will also form a GP except the first term. A1 a2 is never excluded, it's never included, okay? If it is not in AP or GP or HP. And we observe that a2 r d1 is the first term upon common ratio is r. We know that sum of infinite term of a GP is given by A upon 1 minus R, where A means first term is A2RD1. And common ratio, if you find by dividing third term with the second term, D1, D1 cancel, A2, A2 cancel, one of the R is canceled, so it is R. So this is Sn into 1 minus R, and finally, actually it is S infinity. We have to find sum to infinite terms of this GP. So S infinity will be, we divide by 1 minus R to the same side, both side. A1, A2 over 1 minus R plus A2 or D1 over 1 minus R is already there. So it also becomes 1 minus R whole square. So this is the simple method. Multiply by R and then use the method of differences. Is that clear to everyone? And if you have any doubt, then ask it in comment box. So after discussing the general method of finding the sum of an AGP, let's now discuss how to use this method to find the sum of infinite terms of an AGP. So first write this series 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube plus 5x to the power 4 and so on up to infinity. Let's assume that it is equal to S infinity. Okay. Now write the AP. So we observe that AP is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Means its first term is 1 and the common difference is 2 minus 1 equals to 1. Again, write the GP also. It is 1. 1 into 1 is the first term. Second term is x. Third term is x square. Fourth term is x cube and so on up to infinity. Now, first term of this GP is 1 and the common ratio is x by 1 equals to x square by x equals to x. So what should we do? First we write the series as it is. S infinity equals to 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube and so on up to infinity. Then we multiply both sides by common ratio of GP, that is x. So x into sum to infinity equals to this 1 becomes x, 1 into x, x, and shift it one term. 2x becomes 2x square, 3x square becomes 3x cube, and so on up to infinity. Then we find their difference. Subtract equation number 2 from equation number 1. And taking S infinity common from these two into 1 minus x equals to 1 plus. Now 2x minus x is x plus 3x square minus 2x square is x square plus 4x cube minus 3x cube is x cube and so on up to infinity. So it is A upon 1 minus R. Check it. It's a GP. In right hand side, it's a GP. With common ratio x by 1 equals to x square by x equals to x. So ratio is common, so it's a GP. And sum to infinite terms of a GP, we know that it's A upon 1 minus R, in which A equals to 1. This first term of this GP is 1. So A upon 1 minus R is the result of the series in right hand side. So it implies S equals to 1 upon 1 minus X whole square. So this is the final answer of this AGP. S equals to 1 upon 1 minus X whole square. As we have observed that to find the sum to infinite terms of an AGP is easier. So we have started with this only. And in second question, we will explain how to find the sum to n terms of an AGP also. Okay. Now, after discussing this, you can solve, I think, all the questions given in this sheet, like question number B, C, D, etc. So if there is alternative like this question number D, so I'm discussing this one also. how to find the sum of an AGP if it has alternating plus and minus. So let's now discuss question number 1D, which can also be done using the same method. First, we write the series 2 minus 4 by 5 1D. Assume that in place of S infinity, we can use S also for the simplification. First term is 2. Second term is minus 4 by 5. Third term is 6 by 5 square. Fourth term is minus 8 by 5 cube. So what will be the next term? 10 by 5 to the power 4. And so on up to, we have to find its sum till infinity. Now write AP. AP is, first term is, check the first term, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This is AP. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And what is GP? So GP is, first term is 1. S2, 1s are 2. And this plus minus alternate goes with the GP. We know that if common ratio is negative, it will give the alternating positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. So the first one is minus 1 by 5. You can look at this. 4 into 1 by 5 and minus goes with the GP. So minus 1 by 5 is the second term. 1 by 5 square is the third term. Minus 1 by 5 cube is the fourth term. So what will be the common ratio of GP? It will be second term over first term, that is minus 1 by 5. So we multiply both sides by common ratio of GP, that is minus 1 by 5. So first term when multiplied by minus 1 by 5, it gives 2 into minus 1 by 5, that is minus 2 by 5. Second term, minus 4 by 5 is when multiplied by minus 1 by 5, it gives plus 4 by 5 square. And when the third term, 6 by 5 square, is multiplied by minus 1 by 5, what does it give? It gives minus 6 by 5 cube. And then plus 8 by 5 to the power 4 and so on up to infinity. So the next thing what we should do is to subtract equation number 2 from equation number 1. So sign will be changed. This minus becomes plus, this minus becomes plus, this plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus, plus becomes minus and so on up to infinity. So on subtracting, it is S plus 1 by 5S. So it will be 6 by 5S. We know that 1 plus coefficient of S is 1 and coefficient of S becomes positive na, when we change the sign on subtracting. So 1 plus 1 by 5, 6 by 5S equals to, first term is 2 only as there is no term below this, and minus 4 by 5 plus 2 by 5 is minus 2 by 5. 6 by 5 square minus 4 by 5 square is 2 by 5 square. Minus 8 by 5 cube plus 6 by 5 cube is minus 2 by 5 cube. 10 by 5 to the power 4 minus 8 by 5 to the power 4 is plus 2 by 5 to the power 4 and so on up to infinity. It implies 6 by 5s equals to, we can take 2 common from all these terms. So it is giving 1 minus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 square minus 1 by 5 cube and so on up to infinity. So it implies 6 by 5s equals to 2 into, first term is A, which is 1. And this, it's a GP, you can check for this. R equals to second term upon first term, which is minus 1 by 5. And if you divide third term with the second term, it is also giving minus 1 by 5 as the ratio. So it is then a GP, and sum of a GP is obtained by the formula A upon 1 minus R. A is 1 upon R is, we have calculated, minus 1 by 5. So 2 into 1 upon 5 plus 1, 6 by 5, that is 2 into 5 by 6 equals to 5 by 3. This is the value of 6 by 5 into s. Left hand side is 6 by 5 s equals to 5 by 3. And we have to find the value of sum. So s equals to this 5 by 3 into 5 by 6. That is 5 5s are 25 by 18. That's it. Hope you must have understood this theory of finding the sum to infinite terms of a GP. So practice it for question number 1B and 1C and 1E. And let's meet again then. Okay.